click on the subscribe button and remember to press the bell icon for regular notifications from our digital blogger. Hello friends, welcome to our digital blogger. Today we are going to compare Reliance Securities with HDFC Securities. Both are full service stock brokers. HDFC Securities, however, is a bank-based stockbroker on top of it. In this comparison, we will talk about company background, account opening and maintenance charges, brokerage rates, we'll do a small demo as well, exposure or leverage values across segments, research quality, customer service, trading platforms performance, and some of the features that can help you to figure out which of these two stockbrokers is a better choice for you. Let's get started. So starting with the company background, Reliance Securities was established back in the year 2006. It's been good 11-12 years since its establishment. HDFC Securities, on the other hand, is 6 years older to it, launched in the year 2000. Today, they have presence in around 250 locations. So we are exclusively talking about the HDFC Securities branches. We're not talking about HDFC banks. Now, Reliance Securities, on the other hand, has a huge offline presence with sub-brokers and franchise locations in the order of 1,700. However, if you compare it with the likes of other prominent full-service stock brokers such as Motilal or Angel Broking, who have much wider coverage, this is somewhere around average. But still, as far as the comparison between these two brokers is concerned, certainly 1,700 is a good number. It is a member of NSE, BSE and MCXSX, while HDFC Securities holds membership with BSE and NSE. If you talk about the account opening charges, Reliance Security charges you 950 while HDFC Security charges you 1,000 rupees, so almost similar when it comes to trading account. Nothing for the DMAT or the trading account AMC. There is something when it comes to the DMAT account AMC, to 400 rupees as compared to 750. Now these are recurring charges. That basically implies that you have to pay this amount every year to this stock broker here. So certainly HDFC Securities is a tad expensive at the upfront cost. When it comes to brokerage, not much of a difference. Both of these brokers are more or less in a set of premium stock brokers, if we can call it. Now Reliance Securities charges you 0.5% to as low as 0.08. it really depends on multiple plans they have, depending on your initial deposit, depending on your turnover on the stock market and things like that. Similarly, HDFC Securities charges you 0.5% or at your delivery trade. In other segments, more or less they are similar, but here you see a huge difference. Security options is at 100 rupees per lot. Now you can do some calculations if you want. There are different brokerage calculators we have, but make sure that when you talk to the executives of either of these brokers, depending on your initial deposit or various other factors, you can go ahead and negotiate the brokerage charges, because these are the charges that are going to be very heavy on your pocket, especially if you're going to trade at a higher frequency. So let's say if you trade for 1 lakh rupees, you can actually shell out 500 rupees as brokerage for that particular trade only. So I mean, we can actually do a small demo to give you the complete understanding of this. So this is for HDFC Securities. You can just see this one. Go ahead and figure out which particular segment you're looking to put your money into. For this example, we will go ahead with the equity intraday. Let's say you bought a share worth 500 rupees, sold it for, let's say, 600. Number of shares, let's say 100. And state in this example can be Gujarat. This basically helps to decide the stamp duty, this particular charge here. So you go ahead and click on calculate. You see that the corresponding values get populated. Now this is your turnover. Now turnover decides the overall monetary brokerage you're going to pay. In this case, is going to be 0.5% is 550 rupees since it's delivery. STT 110 and similarly other values. Overall taxes and brokerage 774 rupees for this particular turnover. You're going to make a profit of 9,225.62. If we replicate the same example in case of Reliance Securities, and we go ahead and put in the same values of 500 and 650, I guess. So you want to check it. It was 100. So this is 100. Sorry for that. Then we stay, keep the state as Gujarat. There's not going to be a difference here. Point four is something what Reliance Securities is going to charge you. Yes, it depends on your turnover. So higher the turnover, lower is the broker. So in this case, it automatically gets deducted 2.4% of your trade value. As earlier mentioned, you can actually go ahead and negotiate with the executive that you're talking to, and you can get much better brokerage values. And it directly impacts your profit, 9355.42 as compared to 9225.62. So we're talking about one trade here, and obviously higher the number of trades you place, the better profit you make out of these brokers here. Next up, we have exposure or leverage. For people who do not understand this concept, basically it's kind of a short-term loan offered by a stockbroker at a specific rate of interest. This interest rate can be in the range of 15 to, let's say, 22-23%, depending on various factors. Now, Reliance Securities gives you 10 times for intraday and 3 times for delivery. HDFC Securities much better values, 20 times for intraday. Let's say if you have trading account balance of 10,000 rupees, you can trade up to 1 lakh with the Reliance Securities and up to 2 lakh with HDFC Securities. In other segments, there's nothing much to talk about. So as long as you're looking to put your money into equity intraday trades, yes, both of these brokers pose a decent challenge. HDFC Securities is a better one, obviously, here, but nothing ahead to look forward to. You can actually pick out some other broker if you prefer to put your money in either of these segments here. Then we have customer service. Now, Reliance Securities gives you extra communication channel at toll-free number. This is not provided by HDFC Securities, but when it comes to the quality, HDFC Securities actually does a better job here. They have multiple lines of communication. At the same time, they're making sure that they have a decent training in place for their executives who are going to talk to the clients in place. So there is a marginal difference, but yes, there is that difference, and you can pick out HDFC Securities as far as customer service is concerned. Research and trading products. Now, research is very important for beginners. If you're looking to get some initial hand-holding in terms of tips, recommendations, analysis or things like that, yes, you need a full service stock broker for that. A few discount brokers also do it, but prominently full service stock brokers are going to provide you tips and recommendations in any case. But what matters is the accuracy, the regularity of these research reports. And this is where Reliance Securities does a much better job as compared to HDFC. Trading segments, well, not much of a difference. Commodity is one area that you cannot put your money into as long as you're trading with either of these brokers here. Then we have some other features. Now, this is one differentiator, 3-in-1 account. This is only given by bank-based stock brokers, and HDFC Securities certainly does that. So basically what happens is your trading account is linked with your bank account, and the fund transfer process happens automatically. You don't really need to put yourself into it. There's no manual intervention required, and you can just have the fund transfers done automatically. So that is given by HDFC Securities. Automated trading is given by Reliance Securities. So you have to figure out whether you need these features in first place. If you do, then make a choice accordingly. If you don't, then you can move and check out the other requirements. Now we'll talk about the trading platforms. Very important, very crucial. Especially the kind of performance the trading platforms are going to give you, that will decide whether you would be able to put the trade at the right time at the right price. In case the trading platform shuts down, it's end of the story. It doesn't really help being a stockbroker in the first place, right? So we're going to talk about the mobile app first. For that, we need to check out Google Play Store. So first we'll talk about HDFC Securities mobile app. It's called HDFC Securities Mobile Trading. In itself, there's no specific name to it. It's rated at 4.1 by more than 21,000 users, out of which around 11% have rated this app negatively. Overall satisfaction score is somewhere around 88%. If you talk about the update frequency, pretty good. Last update was done on 17th of November 2017. Number of installs, 5 lakh to 1 million. So overall, it's a good app. Update frequencies in the range of 5 to 6 weeks can be improved a bit, but overall decently placed. Number of features are good enough. Concerns are there though. It's relatively bulky, so make sure that the configuration of your phone is decent enough. At the same time, number of technical indicators are limited. So if you want to perform technical analysis, if you are that kind of a person who uses the mobile app, in that case, you might hit a wall very soon. Then there are some login issues that it takes time to log in at times. And there are logout issues where it, in the name of security, logs you out without any notification or alert. And then the overall design can be improved as well at times. So In a sense, it's better than average, but there are some frequent concerns that needs to be taken care of, and people, users, client have been giving a lot of that to HDFC Securities over a period of time now. So still can be improved, but yes, it's a recommended mobile app. Then we have Reliance Tech Pro mobile application from Reliance Securities. It's rated at 3.9 by around 1100 users, out of which around 17% have rated this app negatively. Satisfaction score is somewhere around 83%. At the same time, if we talk about update frequency, the last one was done on 7th of December 2017. In their case, the update frequency cycle is somewhere around 4 weeks, better than HDFC Securities. At the same time, number of installs 50,000 to 1 lakh. Few concerns. It has something similar to HDFC Security, that it also logs you out. It's also relatively bulky, and there is another concern that it does not really allow a lot of customization or personalization as per your requirements. But if you want to pick one, as of now, HDFC Securities wins the battle by a slight margin. The difference is not so huge. You can actually pick either of these mobile apps for your trading, but if you want to pick one of these two, go with HDFC Securities. Now we will talk about the other trading platforms offered by these stock brokers here, and for that we need to check out digitalbroker.com. So we'll start with HDFC Securities. Trading platforms are pretty exhaustive in terms of quality. So they give you Reliance Securities Tick, a terminal-based solution. It gives you big data analytics and robo advisory at the same time. It gives you multiple types of feature. At the same time, even if you are a beginner or an intermediate trader or an expert level trader, it's not going to be a problem in understanding how the application works. The user experience is pretty well designed. Number of features in terms of technical indicators or heat maps or charting types or screeners. So all of that will be present to you. At the same time, since a full service stock broker, they want to give you tips, recommendations, analysis at the same time. So pretty much all in all, it's a recommended software. Tick Pro, the mobile app, we already discussed this, recommended solution. Reliance Commodities is an exclusive mobile application for people who want to trade in commodities segment. So they, obviously they have made sure that the overall features in this particular app are pretty much aligned towards commodity trading. So you can use that one. Then there is Insta Plus. Now this is a browser based application, no download, no install required. Number of features are not that exhaustive as in the case of Reliance Tick. So you have to be a beginner or an intermediate level trader if you want to use this one. It's not mobile responsive. That basically implies that you can just use it on your computer, desktop and laptop. Mobile device will not be able to adopt this particular application itself. Then there is Reliance Securities R Mobile Express. This has been there for a while, but it's getting outdated on a daily basis. So if you want to use mobile application, go with Reliance Tick Pro or the commodities app we just discussed. All in all, good sort of range when it comes to trading platforms across devices, and it comes down to your choice what exactly you are looking for from your trading platform. Then we have the different trading platforms of HDFC Securities. So here they also give you a wide range. They start with HDFC Sec, a browser-based application. No download, no install required. Again, responsive application, so you can use it across any device using any browser. You just need to go to the website of HDFC Securities, click on login, put in your username and password. This is how the application looks like. So that's the basic sort of a design of this application here. Then if we move on and talk about the other sort of trading platforms, then there is HDFC Securities Blink. It's a very mature sort of a trading platform, can be used on your computer and laptop. Number of features are pretty good as well in this case. And of course, you can be any sort of a trader if you want to use this application. Just make sure that you talk to these executives of HDFC Securities, because it's a paid software. So if you want to use this, go ahead. It's going to charge you around 3,000 rupees for 6 months and around 4,000 rupees for 1 year. Unlike in the case of Reliance Tick, which was a free trading application. Now there is a mobile app. We already discussed this one, and you can check out the review if you want by clicking on this link here. We have done the reviews of different trading platforms as well. You just need to click on specific links and you can have a detailed understanding of how these applications work on their own. For example, this is Reliance, the HDFC Securities mobile app with all the features it has. So we're given a detailed 360 degree sort of a look here, and we also talk about positives and negatives of using this application. Similarly, we've done it for HDFC Securities Blink, the terminal based solution, the paid one, just to remind you on that. But also we talk about different screens, different layouts, different features. We also give you pros and cons, so you can check out all of that. That will be available on the review links of these stock brokers here. Now it comes down to the point whether and what kind of a device you want to use. So if you want to use, let's say, a terminal solution, go with the Reliance Stick version. It's a free one. You can go with Blink one if you are open to pay that amount of money, but yeah, you get value as well. For the web application, you can go ahead with HDFC Sec, certainly better. And in the case of mobile app as well, Reliance Stick Pro is okay, but there is a slight marginal sort of a win for HDFC Securities mobile app as well. So all in all, both of these stock brokers pose a decent competition to each other, and certainly they have a reasonable focus on technology as well when it comes to trading platforms. So that is it as far as comparison between these two full service stock brokers is concerned. We talked about multiple features here. Start with the company, backgrounds, pricing, exposure, research, service, platforms, products. Now you have to see what exactly you want, and based on that you can make a choice for yourself. You can check out the comparison as well, and in case you want a suggestion from our end in finalizing a stock broker that matches exactly with your requirements, you can check out this link here, digitalblogger.com/free-call-back-broker-choice. Put in your details and preferences. We will be setting up a call back for you absolutely free. So that's it for the video. Thank you so much for watching it. We hope you liked it. In case you did, please go ahead and press the like icon. We'll really appreciate that. You can also subscribe to our different social media channels, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, SlideShare, and YouTube, with the same handle, our digital blogger, where we post content on a regular basis. Thank you so much again for watching this video. Bye.